Terima kasih Ifa untuk laporan sukan itu. Dan segmen B Diva malam ini kami kongsikan tentang sebuah lagu patriotik baharu yang berjudul Patriotik Jaya Sayangi Malaysiaku.
Juga kisah Afro, sebuah platform penyediaan perkhidmatan penganjuran acara. Saksikan segmen B Diva.
Perpaduan vokal kepelbagaian kaum yang menyanyikan lagu Patriot Jaya Sayangi Malaysiaku bersempena Hari Kebangsaan Malaysia yang menjelang tiba pasti membangkitkan lagi semangat perpaduan dalam kalangan masyarakat. Apa yang menariknya, lagu dan lirik ciptaan Bro Rem dan Ezra Rosman Haris ini telah menggabungkan artis berbilang kaum termasuk bekas penyanyi kumpulan Damasutra Bagio, Winnie K. Reshma, Natasha Sass, Zairul Talia, Yana Yunus, Lobo Panglima, Amir Aswadi dan Radhi Khalid.
Kalau selama ni kita tercari-cari untuk sesuatu naskah lagu yang semuanya penggunaan bahasa Malaysia secara 100%, dinyanyikan secara berbilang kaum, inilah dia Patriot Jaya.
Oh, so Winnie rasa sangat seronok dan Winnie rasa bangga dan semangat sebagai rakyat Malaysia dapat nyanyi lagu patriotik sebab lagu ni memang sangat bermakna. Jadi sebagai warga negara, Winnie rasa sangat bangga nak nyanyi lagu patriotik.
I am representing Malaysians. I rasa label-label dari secara race tak sangat penting when you remember that we are all Malaysian, kan? And Reshma, dia tinggal di New Zealand, Sarawak, I've been everywhere, you know? Tetapi the one thing that I can say is that I am a Malaysian and I am from this country. And Reshma sangat bangga untuk jadi orang Malaysia lah. I'm so proud that I am a Malaysian dan saya harap lagu ni reflect idea itu, yeah.
Pelancaran lagu tersebut telah diadakan baru-baru ini dan ia merupakan hasil usaha sama konsortium Irama dan Naf Karaoke Keluarga. Sebuah platform yang dapat membantu penghibur, selebriti, penyanyi, pelakon mahupun pengacara untuk menjana pendapatan dan mengembangkan peluang melalui karier dan bakat mereka tersendiri. Afro, sebuah media platform teknologi telah dirasmikan baru-baru ini selepas melabuhkan perniagaan mereka di Singapura dan Thailand semenjak tahun 2017.
Right, and I really like the fact that, you know, there's so much more talents and people are the kind of talents that we have in Malaysia, like I was sharing in the press conference. In Singapore, we have like what? One sand sculptor, like in Malaysia we like 10-15 of them, right? And this is pretty much why we are in Malaysia, because we know that the resources in Singapore is limited, but Malaysia can actually be like a resource land for us, right? And we can actually allow Malaysian talents to actually go international with our platform, whether is it going to Malaysia or going to Thailand or is it going to Singapore. I think this platform it's able to do that for them.
Pelancarannya turut dimeriahkan dengan kehadiran selebriti tanah air seperti Rashid Saleh, Nita Hamzah, Adeline Sen, Amar Alfian dan ramai lagi.
Afro inviting me untuk kalau ikutkan, yalah, this is about the event organisation. Okay, so bagi I sebenarnya, yalah, kadang-kadang kita sekarang dah banyak sangat orang kata selebriti, artis and all. So kadang-kadang betul juga apa orang cakap, macam tadi ada a few question yang orang tanya kan, macam mana kalau misalnya artis tu ada talent tapi tak boleh nak ke mana. So mungkin Afro will macam ada jalan untuk artis-artis yang orang tak nampak. Bagi saya lah.
Yes, I think it's a great platform to have, especially for the younger generation, because we never had anything like that. Talents in the past, obviously what he was talking about, having people having to, you know, go through countless of hours of trawling through, you know, getting information about talents, getting information about event, and you, it's mostly hearsay. So what they've done is cut down the time for us. And especially for the newer talents, especially those doing emceeing for events, and it's very much an events-based platform. It's good because you don't have to worry. Hopefully in the long run, you don't have to worry, because one thing they said, quality. So you don't have to worry about the talent that you'll be hiring, and also the event organizer. So also, you know, as I mentioned before, one, the you will get quality emceeing because it will all pan out in the long run, and you have event organizers or event management teams who will be accountable for their actions. And at the end of the day, the client will benefit from it. So I'm really glad that something like this is happening.
EFRO merupakan layaran pusat senti dalam talian bagi penyediaan perkhidmatan penganjuran acara, pada masa sama mewujudkan sebuah peluang menjana pendapatan bagi golongan penghibur industri.